Welcome back to JLPT N5 Masterclass. In this section, you will learn about basic adjective. If you are ready, I want to start with number one for this lesson. This kanji is mean own. Furui. Onyomi is ko. Kunyomi is furui. It means furui. And the vocabulary in JLPT N5, you only have to memorize this furui. Okay, try to draw this kanji. Very easy. Have to beware. This. Okay. Go to next kanji. Is mean many. Oi. O-O-E. Oi. Kungyomi is oi. It mean many. It mean many. Okay, for example, hito ga oi desu. Hito ga oi desu. Oi. This. It mean there are many people. Okay. Next kanji is big or large. Onyomi is dai or tai. Dai. Kungyomi is oki. Ki. Oki. It means large or big. In this Japanese N5, you only have to memorize this. Oki. It means big. Okay. And there is a irregular pronoun for otona. 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 Is oto and hito. Hito and oi. It means adult. Adult. Otona, and oki. Daigaku is university. Daigaku, university. Okay, go to next kanji is yasui. It means cheap price, yasui, cheap. Okay. You have to memorize this. Yasui. Kungyomi is yasui. Onyomi is an. But in the basic adjective is yasui. Okay, try to draw. Let's draw this kanji. Okay. Okay. Next kanji is small, little or small. Jisai. Kungyomi is jisai. And you have to only memorize this jisai. Only one vocabulary. Jisai. But you have to be careful about jisai, ji and sai. You have to put sai after ji, after this kanji, sai. Okay, next kanji is few or little. Sukunai, sukunai, sukunai. Sukunai. Few or little. You have to be careful. Maybe use a lot of you have confused with jisai, but sukunai is have some more stroke in this stroke to be careful. Next kanji is new, something new. Ongyomi is chin, shin. Ongyomi is chin, shin. And kungyomi is atara and shi. Atarashi, shin. In N5, there is only one vocabulary for the combination of two kanjis. Shinbun. Shinbun is mean shin is mean new. New. Yes. New. And you will see in next lesson. For this kanji, kiku, kiku, it means listen. Listen something news. It means newspaper. It means news. It means news. Okay. Adjective is atarashi. Atarashi is mean new. Okay. Next, this color is white, bright, bright. White color, white color. Ongyomi is haku, and kungyomi is shiro, and shiroi, shiroi. In N5, only shiroi, you have to memorize shiroi. Okay, let's try to write. And I, shiroi. Next kanji is wrong, 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 long. Ongyomi is cho, kungyomi is nangai, nanga, nangai, nangai. Okay, it's nangai, wrong, something wrong. Okay, let's try to write this kanji. 2, 3. Is nangai. Okay. Next kanji is takai. Takai. Takai is mean tall, high, or expensive. Expensive is also means takai. Nidan, for example, nidan ga. Price is expensive. The price is expensive. Okay, and is seika takai. Seika takai is mean that person are tall. Is tall. Tatemono or building is tall. Is also can say tatemono ga takai, is tall. And you can remember only this vocabulary takai. Next kanji is jikai, 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 jikai. near, near, nearby something, close by something, 近い. Kungyomi is 近い. Ongyomi is king, king. 近い. You have to only memorize this word, 近い. Next kanji is this is last kanji for this lesson. There are in many textbook or the famous website for JLPT N5, but this kanji is for N4, but I think you have to maybe it's good for you to remember this kanji, because if you remember the adjective, you have to memorize the pair of adjective. For example, jikai and toi, near and far, distant is better for you. Then I add this kanji for you. Okay, this toi. Toi, toi, far or distant. Okay, let's try to write this kanji.